Nabanja's speech was delivered by the local government minister, Victoria Businge Rusoke. The minister observed that quite a number of schools have neglected teaching culture in schools.
The thematic curriculum is very clear that P1 to P3, bege mundi mizabo. Baitu, our competition, nagontu gamba or rulimi nago barwegesa as a subject, but adunagira kimu. To an extent of gamba, this school we speak only English, other language are hit straight. We don't think, no. It's pride and it helps interpretation for a child to learn the mother tongue and then interpret. I want to emphasize this, especially to you parents. Many of you think speaking English is academic excellence. Na wana mimutamu kuba juma na kuba hahaza, mkawaki ni wabaza indimizanyo.
She stressed that children should be given a chance to learn and understand their culture and tradition at an early age. School administrators have been urged to impart values of transparency, hard work and faithfulness among the young generation.
The Right Honourable Nabanja is thanking you for providing education. It is a sacrifice. She thanks you. She's encouraging you to have an all-round child. Skilling should begin here in primary. Faithfulness, transparency, God-fearing values, hard work, knowledge of their culture, obedience, discipline, and God-fearing values. So she says that is a better school that embraces all that. A nursery school, a primary school, are the foundation.
Emmanuel Businge, the Fort Porto resident city commissioner, applauded the government for the peace and stability that has contributed to the development of the education sector.
These days it is very easy to bring your kid or your child in a baby school, in a baby class, and you see him or her complete university without running up and down. Long ago it was not easy. People could be refugees in other countries, but now with the peace and stability, we are sure that the children we bring to school will complete school without any hindrances. Thank the parents for prioritizing education. There is no better investment than education. In our offices as RDCs or RCCs for that matter, we receive very many complaints, especially conflicts regarding land. We receive more complaints with people fighting over land. All estates left by parents.
Helen Atwoki, the school head teacher, called on the government to consider supporting private education institutions in handling special needs children.
To provide a caring environment in which every child is respected and given the opportunity to develop characters and values to excel in their generation. To have upright, God-fearing pupils and teachers, to have future self-reliable and hard-working citizens of the motherland Uganda, to impart the culture norms and customs among our learners and use them in their day-to-day life experiences.
Story by Roger Sunday for the News Info Portal.